everybody. We're on our way to a wedding ceremony and reception in Chipley, Florida. Well, officially the address is Chipley, but we're really close to Vernon, Florida. So we're kind of quite a ways from the town of Chipley, but anyway, it's got a Chipley address. And both Vernon and Chipley are close to Panama City, so that gives you kind of a reference where we are. We're about 2.5 hours away from Pensacola. And this is going to be at a private residence. Now, this is going to be set up just a little bit differently than what we're usually used to. You know, normally whenever I do a ceremony or reception, I usually have one set up for the ceremony and one set up for the reception. And usually, you know, I use the Fender passport for the ceremony to break it down immediately after, and everybody moves to the reception area. Well, the way this is going to be set up today is where the dancing is going to be taking place is right there where the ceremony is going to be taking place, kind of in the same area. So I'm going to set up my main sound system that I normally set up right there on a patio area, and we're going to use that for the ceremony. Okay, and then they've got a separate area where everybody's going to be eating. I think it's a shed that they've got, and they're going to have tables set up in there, and that's where everybody's going to be eating. So I'm going to set up the Fender passport in there, and what we're going to do is I'm going to use that for the wedding party introductions and for the dinner, and then the toast and the cake cutting will be done there. And then as soon as the toast and the cake cutting are over with, we're going to move back over to the patio area where my main system is set up, and that's where we'll do the spotlight dances, the open dancing, and then conclude the reception there. So that's where all that will be taking place. So again, a little bit differently. You'll see how things go once we get there. But anyway, we're probably about 15-20 minutes away from the venue right now. It's about 12:40, so ceremony's supposed to start today at 3:30, so I should get there in plenty of time to get everything set up, and we'll be talking to you throughout the day. We're supposed to go until 10 o'clock tonight, so yeah, very long day, but you know what? It's going to be well worth it in the end. I'll talk to you once we get there, once we get set up. Okay, it's about 3:40 now. We're supposed to start our ceremony about 4 o'clock. I thought the ceremony was actually going to start at 3:30, but actually we're going to start it at 4. But anyway, I'm standing where the dance floor is going to be. Let me show you my setup. This, of course, is the reception and the ceremony setup tonight. For the open dancing, anyway, and spotlight dances. I tried something new tonight. I've got the park hands that I normally have on the speaker stands. Decided to put them on the floor this time and see how they work. The last couple times I've had them behind the facade, but I decided to try it on the floor to see how that works. They're not shining. Okay, so here we are in the area where they're going to be eating dinner. Let me show you this real quick. See the table set up here. Of course, the chairs aren't here right now because they're all out at the out there for the ceremony. I've got their monogram up there behind the head table. You can't see it right now. You will be able to see it though once it gets dark. And we've got some up lights. I've got a couple of the bar lights over here. I got my battery powered up lights over there. I want to actually turn those on when it gets dark. But here's my Fender passport. And this will be where we'll be doing everything for dinner. So real simple to, you know, set up and break down right here. And then there's a monogram projector. Okay, ceremony's over with right now, and they're having everybody have a picture with the bride and groom. That's pretty neat. I don't think I've done a wedding where they've done that before, but I like that. Clever idea. Okay, so here's the dinner set up tonight, once again. In the passport. Wedding party back over there taking their pictures. Beautiful sunset right back over there. Okay, it's just gotten dark, and you can see my reception set up right up there with some up lighting. And then where we're having dinner, just right over here, you can see my second sound system there, the Fender passport right there on that table. And enjoying some barbecue there from Mission Barbecue in Panama City, Florida. So if you're ever in Panama City, go check them out.
Family and have many inside jokes. But that's really everything I had to say. So I guess let's raise a glass and toast.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
I'm Dance's brother, for people you might not know that, but I don't have really much to say other than the fact that I grew up with Dennis my whole entire life. We've been together through everything, like living with him, everything, a whole bunch of stuff. And I've seen him go through relationships before, you know, but when I see him with Lizzie, it's like he's a whole new man. Like there's nothing you would ever recognize from him now, from when he growing up. He's completely different. And just,
now for the roast.
hope you're having fun tonight. I know we are. We are so happy to be here tonight to celebrate Lizzie and Dennis, the new Kennedys. We will always be here for you, Lizzie, no matter what. And Dennis, we are your family now too. Part of our family for, you know, as long as we can remember. You guys all know. You guys all know about Granny Baby. She's been with us for so many family events. Mom and Tony's wedding 10 years ago. Birthdays, Christmas, Lizzie's bachelorette party last weekend. Granny Baby could not miss out on Lizzie and Dennis' special day. She had to be.
Let's Can you bring it to the top? One hop. Right foot now. Left foot now, y'all. Cha-cha, real smooth.
So it's now about 3:45 on a Sunday afternoon, and like a lot of DJs on Sunday after a wedding, I normally just kind of relax. That's what I did today. I mean, it was kind of a day that I just slept in and laid around in my pajamas all day, watched movies and stuff like that. So anyway, I decided to go ahead and do a quick wrap for this wedding gig log that you just saw. It took place yesterday. And as I said, this was a wonderful bride and groom, wonderful group of friends and family, and everything went great. And if you notice, as I mentioned before in the intro, and I think you probably saw throughout the gig log, is that we had two sound systems set up. And we had the Fender Passport set up in the shed. That's where they were having their dinner. We did the wedding party introductions. We had dinner in there. We also did the toast and the cake cutting in there as well. And the reason for that is I wanted them to be able to have some music and for us to be able to do the wedding party introductions and everything there instead of having everybody come outside on the patio to do all those things like the toast and all that kind of stuff. I figured it'd be a whole lot easier to just do it in there in the shed with everybody, you know, there at their tables and stuff. So that's kind of what we did. So we did the wedding party introductions there. We had dinner in there. We also, like I said, did the toast and the cake cutting, and then after that, we moved over to the patio area where we did the bouquet throw and all the spotlight dances and then the open dancing and the conclusion of the reception. So that's basically how that worked out. And that was actually my suggestion to the bride and groom. I had gone and met with them back in July and seen the facility, and that was my suggestion to do that. And, you know, as I said before, you know, with the ceremony, it was right there by the patio, so I just used my reception setup for the ceremony, and that went great, too. It got started a little bit late, but, you know, to be honest with you, I've been mobile DJ almost 20 years. Next year is going to be 20 years that SNDJ Entertainment has been in business, and I can probably count on one hand about how many weddings have actually gotten started right on time. Usually, there's usually a delay on most weddings, which is fine. I mean, that's, you know, we just roll with the punches whenever that happens. It's no big deal, and that's kind of what happened yesterday, but you know what? It all worked out in the end. The bride and groom had a wonderful time, and the all their friends and family were just really nice. I had a really great time getting the chance to meet with them and talk to them and take their request, and everybody was just really fun. And it was just a really fun group. I hope to be able to do more events for them. And I gave them my business card and told them, hey, call me again. You know, I'd gladly go back and do another event there for them if they have any parties or anything like that. So, yeah, that's where we're going to leave this. This was another successful bride and groom. And you know what? This just shows why we love what we do. And, you know, yesterday just seeing everybody out there having fun, that really just reiterated why I got into this business to begin with. So that's where we're going to leave this. We got more gig logs to come. So until next time, practice and enjoy. Yeah, girl, before you leave.